Hey there, folks, it's me, Michael Bach, and this is Monday Morning Musings. Happy Monday. I hope this finds you well, safe, and healthy. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Thanks so much for spending some time with me. Please do remember to subscribe by clicking on the link which is somewhere around me to find out whenever I post a video, which is every Monday except when it's not like last Monday. But there's a reason. I didn't post a video last Monday. Sorry. But I was waiting for a couple court cases to be decided. And I kept waiting and waiting, and then it just got too late, and then I didn't post it. And I thought, oh, well, I'll just wait till next week. So here I am, next week. So the two court cases, I'm sure you can guess. One was the trial of Derek Chauvin in Minneapolis, Minnesota. He is now officially been found guilty of all charges related to the murder of George Floyd. Fantastic. Yay. It's a step in the right direction. Eight white jurors agreed that he had murdered George Floyd. That is a step in the right direction. It's not the total package, but at least we're moving in the right direction. But the case that really has me upset is in Quebec City specifically, where the court was hearing a challenge to, or several challenges to, Bill 21, which is the so-called secularism law in Quebec. And unfortunately, the court was forced to uphold the law because the Quebec government had included the notwithstanding clause, which basically says, screw you to the Charter of Rights and Freedoms. And the court, it was Justice Blanchard, overtly said that he had no choice. Now, he did, the law does not cover English schools now, although it is being challenged. But English-speaking schools will be permitted to eventually hire people who wear religious symbols, which overtly affects Muslim women who wear the niqab and the hijab. Once it goes through its challenges, it looks like that will stand. But for everybody else, we still have to deal with Bill 21. And if you're not familiar, I'll paste a couple links down below. But one of the things that came out in the press this week is that liberal leader Dominique Anglade, I think it's Anglade or Anglade, has said that she would not renew the notwithstanding clause. It has to be renewed every 5 years. That she would not renew it if she formed government. And François Legault, the premier of Quebec, has said that she has failed a leadership test, that she's letting down Quebecers because she would not allow what is a racist law to stand. And that's what it tells me. He knows full well that this law, if it were challenged in court, would be found to be against the Charter of Rights and Freedoms. The Charter of Rights and Freedoms that protects his right to speak French as a primary language. This law is nothing shy of government-sanctioned racism. And it is unacceptable. It is un-Canadian. I would encourage you to reach out to Premier Legault, to any of his MLAs, and make sure that he knows how unacceptable this is. He needs to wake up. This is un-Canadian. It is undemocratic. Clearly, I'm upset. Anyway, that's it for me. I hope you have a fantastic week. Thanks for tuning in. Remember to subscribe and also like and share this video with all of your friends on social media. They really want to hear this. I don't know if they do, but pretend they do. And connect with me on social media. I am at the Michael Bach. Also, if you haven't already done so, check out my book, my best-selling book, Birds of All Feathers, Doing Diversity and Inclusion Right, available now wherever you buy books, as long as they're selling mine. Or you can go to my website at michaelbach.com and click on the books to find out where you can get your copy. I hope you have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next Monday for another episode of Monday Morning Musings. Bye.